Dear students, today we'll be reading about the human digestive system. The human digestive system is basically studied as alimentary canal and associated gland. Here you can see, I have just for your idea, I have drawn the face. You see eye, the forehead, the nose. Here is the mouth. This is the place from where the digestive system starts, right? So this digestive system, we have already read about the teeth and the tongue. And this passage I have drawn, can you see this passage is mouth cavity, right? So first we will see the parts of the digestive system that make the alimentary canal. Canal means a passage for the food to be processed. You see, you ingest food, you eat food here, the food comes with the help of tongue and mouth, the food passes through this, comes into this bag-like structure, continues passing through this small thin pipe, and then through this thick pipe, and ultimately to this rectum and out. Right? From here, out. Food is pushed out. So here is the entry of the food. Here is the exit, right? Exit of the food means the food goes in this, processed in this system, and unwanted material is pushed out as the fecal matter. Do you remember? So see, alimentary canal, what parts of the digestive system they make the alimentary canal, right? So you see, I will label the parts, the parts that make the alimentary canal, right? So this first part is mouth. You must know the names. So in alimentary canal, what are the parts? First one is mouth, right? Then second, after the mouth, you see the mouth is having the teeth and the tongue, right? So this whole mouth, teeth, tongue. In the previous video, I have already discussed about the functions of these parts. The mouth is the opening through which or via which you can put the food in the mouth, right? So just keeping the food in the mouth is called ingestion. Do you remember? Keeping the food in the mouth is called ingestion. Then after keeping, once you keep the food in the mouth, what happens? These teeth become functional, the tongue become functional, they become active. What do the teeth do? The teeth, they mechanically make the food smaller in size, that is, they break the food physically. You have already read about the teeth. The human beings, they have four different kinds of teeth. Do you remember? The front teeth called incisors, the corner teeth canines, then after the canines you have the premolars, and at the last you have the molars, right? So we have four different kinds of teeth that work in the process of digestion, and these teeth, they cut, they tear, they chew, they grind the food. These are the four types of functions they perform. And then the tongue. What does the tongue do? Tongue helps the crushed food, the broken food, to mix with the saliva. I told this saliva is secreted by salivary gland. It's a liquid substance, what you commonly know as spit. Right? So the food is mixed with the spit. It doesn't seem good to say that food is mixed with the spit, no? But chemically, this spit or the saliva that is secreted by, that is given out or discharged inside this mouth cavity by these salivary glands, right? Later on we will read about these associated glands, then I will talk of the salivary gland. So this tongue, what is the work of the tongue? Then tongue mixes the food with the saliva, right? And after mixing the food thoroughly into the with the saliva, this tongue pushes the food forward, right? So forward, here you see the second portion, this portion of the digestive system or alimentary canal is known as esophagus, or you can, in a simple words, you may have read it as the food pipe, right? So remember here one thing, this food pipe is a muscular structure made up of muscles, right? And this food, you should remember that when the food reaches here, suppose this is the food, it does not fall down due to the effect of gravity. See, this chalk, suppose the food is, this chalk is representing the food. If I leave this chalk here at this place, what is happening to the chalk? The chalk has fallen down, right? The chalk has fallen down. Clear? Why has it happened? If I keep this food here and it goes downwards, what is the reason? The gravity, the pull of gravity. Gravity has pulled. But here it is not so. Remember, it's not due to gravity. Right? What happens? This food pipe just squeezes the food to push it forward and relaxes. Then contracts, then relax, then contracts and relax. So this way what happens? This movement takes place in the esophagus, and this movement of pushing the food to further towards the stomach is known as peristalsis. Peristalsis, right? You must remember, peristalsis is the muscular activity of the food pipe that pushes the food downwards or reaches the food into the stomach. The next part of the alimentary canal is this stomach. Is stomach is a bag like structure. See, we have read, we have recognized these structures. I am just making the line thick so that you can understand. This is a bag like structure, right? And the food comes here in this bag like structure, right? So this is the stomach, that is next part of the alimentary canal. So I'll, for recalling, alimentary canal starts from here, mouth, teeth, tongue, then esophagus or food pipe. The next structure in the alimentary canal is stomach, and this stomach continues as small intestine. Small intestine means this structure. This is a thin pipe. This is a thin pipe, but a long one. You can see this thin pipe that continues up to, it develops into a thick pipe. So this thin pipe, but long as compared to the large intestine, is long, as much as some 20-21 feet, right? So this structure is known as, this thin pipe is known as small intestine. This thin pipe, we later on read them as duodenum, jejunum and ileum, and they make small intestine. Now you should see why the name small, not the large. The reason is this small intestine, the name may be given because the cross section or the thickness of this pipe is less, less thickness, right? This thickness is not very big cross section. The cross section is very small, right? And then this small intestine continues as the large intestine, right? This small intestine continues as the large intestine. You can see this one is large intestine. Why the name large intestine? I have told you, it's because the cross section or thickness of this pipe. I'm using the word pipe so that you can understand. This is a pipe-like structure that allows the passage of the food through it for processing, right? So up to this, so this whole structure, that is large intestine, large intestine. So you must remember we have two different kinds of intestine in our alimentary canal, and that is the small intestine and the large intestine, right? Small intestine, the name is small intestine because the cross section is thin, and the large intestine because this is a thick pipe, right? Is this big cross section, right? Though the length of this small intestine is far more than as compared to this large intestine. And then comes the last part of the alimentary canal. And the last part of the alimentary canal is this one, again a bag-like collector, a bag-like collector, and the name of this is rectum, right, is rectum. And ultimately this rectum is having an opening, and through this opening the waste, unwanted part of the food is pushed out of the body, and this is known as anus. Anus, A-N-U-S, anus, right? So we'll recall the parts of the alimentary canal. Parts of the alimentary canal: mouth, teeth, tongue, then the food pipe or esophagus. Then from food pipe you have this bag like stomach, and stomach continues as small intestine, that is further read as duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Small intestine, the part that starts from stomach and to some extent is duodenum, the middle part is jejunum, and the last part that opens in the large intestine is ileum, right? So this way small intestine, and then comes the large intestine, and at the last rectum and anus, right? So these are the paths of the alimentary canal of the human digestive system. The second aspect, that is associated glands. So before going ahead, I should tell you what is a gland. Gland is actually a mass, a small soft structure. It may be of different shape, right? This may be a gland, right? Just a mass. And what is the function? These glands, they become active when they are supposed to be. Their activity is involuntary. Involuntary means it depends on our internal thoughts or the activity. We need not ask them. It's not voluntary that we say, hey glands, you start working. No, they will not work. They will work of their own when they are required to work in automated system in our body, right? It's an automated system in our body. And in this, what happens? These glands, they secrete some chemicals in the liquid form, right? In liquid or semi-liquid form, and these liquid or semi-liquid forms, they are known as the enzymes. Enzymes, right? They are known as enzymes. So the liquid that is secreted by the glands is known as enzymes. These enzymes contain different chemical substances which are essentially required to treat or process the food chemically. Clear? So, associated glands, we start from beginning. I have told you at this place, near your chin, then at the juncture of your lower jaw and the corner of your lower jaw. We have these glands known as salivary glands. Salivary glands. And what is their function or how are they recognized? They secrete salivary amylase. This is the enzyme. I told the chemical substances in liquid form that the glands secrete that help in the processing of food chemically, they are called the enzymes. So this salivary gland present here near your chin at this place, then this corner and at this jaws, right? And recently some more salivary glands are traced, right? So these glands, they keep secreting the salivary amylase that contains a chemical substance or tyline, and this helps in the digestion of complex starch in the food to maltose. Is that clear? So the first associated gland with our digestive system is the salivary gland. Then when we move further, the next one we have this liver. This liver secretes bile, right? And this bile helps in the emulsification of fat. Now you may ask to, sir, what is emulsification of fat, right? Just listen me carefully. Put some oil, you have the coconut oil in your house, or you have the mustard oil in your house. You just put some oil in your hand and just coat it all over the surface of your palm. Now your palm becomes oily. Clear? Do you follow? What you have to do? Take little of coconut oil or mustard oil or any edible oil that you have in your house, put in your palm and just coat it all over your palm. Right? Now you see your palm becomes oily, coated with oil, right? You just go, if I ask you, go and wash your hands, and you go to the wash basin, start the tap, put your hand under the tap, and you just let the water run, fall in your palm, keep rubbing against. You will, after some time, what you will see, though you have used up even a bucket of water to wash this oily coating on your palm, is not going. Will it go with water? No. Then you come to me, ask, sir, is not going, is it still oily? I have washed it with nearly one bucket of water I used to wash it. Right? Will not go. Why? The answer to this question is because this oil that is coated on your palm is not soluble in water. Not soluble in water means, you will understand this fact, take a small bottle, put some water, put some oil in that, cap it, shake it briskly how much you want, and leave it for some time. You will see after some time the water will be at the bottom and the oil will come above as two different layers. You can easily see them. They are not going to mix. This is their property. In chemistry we will read about the properties, but this is the feature, the character, that oil never mixes with water. It's not soluble. Oil is not soluble in water, right? Then what to do? How to remove this? Then I say, you go, take little of detergent powder in your hand or a soap, a toilet soap, you take, rub against your palm, and then just after putting that soap, put your hand under the water. What you will see, oh my God, all this oil will be gone from your palm. Now what happened? This oil is chemically treated with what? With a base alkali, the soap, right? And this fat gets dissolved in the water with the help of soap. Means in that bottle where you kept that oil and water together, add some detergent powder and then mix, and you will see after some time the water and oil will mix. Do this experiment at home, okay? So if they mix, same thing happens with this bile. This bile helps in the emulsification of fats. Emulsification means breaking this fat molecules, oil molecules, in so smaller size that they get dissolved in water, that is, they become soluble in water. Most of the times we take oily food, and this oily food will not be acted upon by the enzymes if it is not soluble, or if it is not water soluble, you can say, right? If it is not water soluble, it will not work, right? Then what happened? This is called emulsification of fat. Emulsification of fat means this liquid, this gland, the next important the gland in our digestive system is the liver. And remember one important question, generally in the examination it is asked, name the biggest gland in our body. So your answer will be the liver is the biggest gland in our body. Clear? So what is the biggest gland in our body? Liver. Now my question, what type of enzyme does this liver secrete? This liver secretes bile, this bile. And what is the work of bile? This bile helps in the emulsification of fat. I have told you emulsification of fat. Do you remember emulsification of fat? It is just turning the fat to become soluble in water, right? And sometimes if there is no fat, not enough fat, then this bile gets stored in this gallbladder, right? Here you have a small bladder like structure, not in the stomach, it is just below, behind. This is a separate structure. I have drawn it in the stomach because you will not able to follow. Connected with this liver. So this, in this gallbladder is a small structure, a bladder like structure, a small pouch like structure, right? Small packet like structure in which this bile juice is stored to be used from time to time, right? You may have heard people suffering from this hepatitis or this jaundice. In that case, this liver get affected and people are asked not to take oily substances because that will not get digested and will just coat whole of this inner lining, inner surface of this alimentary canal and will not help absorb the nutrients from them right after digestion. So the next important gland associated with our digestive system is liver, and liver secretes the enzyme bile. And what is the function of the bile? The function of the bile is emulsification of fat. I have told you about emulsification of fat. And this bile juice is stored in gallbladder, a small pouch like structure, and this is stored. And the next one associated gland is pancreatic gland or pancreas. This is pancreatic gland or pancreas. What it secretes? The pancreatic juice that is made up of three different kinds of enzymes. This pancreatic juice is made up of trypsin, lipase and pancreatic amylase. Three different kinds of enzymes, right? What is their function? Whatever protein you have separated from your food, that complex protein with the action of this trypsin changes into peptides. The fat with the action of this lipase turns into fatty acid and glycerols, and with this pancreatic amylase the starch turns into maltose. Now what is the use of turning them into from one kind of product to the other one? The reason is this protein is a complex substance. it cannot be used directly by our body. So I have told you in your previous video that digestion is, main purpose of digestion is that simplification of molecules or converting the complex molecules to simple absorbable form. I have told you separating out, taking out the simple form of that particular nutrient. We have read about the nutrients. You remember carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. So see, and this way, so important glands at your level that you should remember is the salivary gland, the liver, the pancreatic gland. These three important glands at your level you must remember. Now I will talk about the processing of the food. So our digestive system or the human digestive system is read under two heading: alimentary canal, associated gland. Alimentary canal is made up of mouth, teeth, tongue, then food pipe, this esophagus, then bag like structure stomach, and in the this from stomach continues into a thin long, a very large pipe known as the small intestine, and this small intestine opens in a thick pipe that is known as large intestine. This large intestine opens in a bag like structure, a collector of fecal matter. Rectum is collector of fecal matter. This is a collector. Collector of matter. That is unwanted part of the food. Or the food, the part of the food, it is simply, if you go to the market, in a bag, in a polythene bag, you purchase the potatoes. Potatoes you needed, you kept in your kitchen, and the polythene bag you have thrown it in the dustbin. Same way, this chapati is a bag containing the carbohydrate. You have taken out the carbohydrate, and the remaining part of the chapati is pushed out fecal matter. Right. So this is all about the digestive system in human being. Now about their functioning. How do they function? About their functioning. About the functioning in the mouth, I have already discussed in the previous video that when you put the steps of nutrition in the steps of nutrition in the human beings, you have read as ingestion, then digestion, then absorption, then assimilation and egestion. Do you remember the steps? So ingestion is putting the food in the mouth. Then digestion starts here in the mouth itself. In the mouth, the digestion of complex starch starts. That is complex sugar molecules is converted into maltose. Clear? So the digestion starts. After digestion, you know, so you this food is pushed through this with the help of the tongue, it is pushed in the esophagus. And esophagus, I have told you, is a muscular pipe which constricts to push the forward. If the food comes here, then constricts here, then pushed further. So by pushing it, otherwise you see, you should not confuse that food goes here and drops down into the stomach. It's not so. Remember, it's because of this peristaltic movement, I have told you, the esophagus, it pushes the food into the stomach. Stomach is a bag-like structure, and this stomach secretes, in stomach also there is secretion of one chemical substance, that is gastric juice. The inner lining, the inner wall of the stomach secretes gastric juice. This gastric juice contains pepsin and dilute hydrochloric acid. Oh my God, it'll be acid inside our stomach. Yes, acid inside our stomach. What is the reason? Why do we need acid in our stomach? It's because acid kills the bacteria and germs. You know, bacteria and germs cause us diseases, and bacteria and fungus that may have gone due to unhygienic food practices that may have entered up to your stomach, if they will remain there, what will happen? If they will remain outside, you throw the chapati. After few days, you or a potato, if you throw, you see it becomes stale and rottening starts, and it starts. It's giving foul smell also. What is the reason? Reason is because this is acted upon the bacteria and fungus. The microbes act on that, and when they act on, they decompose it. They turn it into a rotten substance, right? If the germs will exist in your food, in the stomach, what will they do? They will just decompose it, turn it into a rotten substance, and that food will be of no use to our body. That will be merely a waste and unnecessary activity. The processing will be done, and the person will not get the nutrient required. So, in the gastric juice, you have the dilute HCl, that is dilute hydrochloric acid, that kills the germs present or bacteria or microbes present in the food that have come along with your food because of unhygienic food practices. And this pepsin, at this level also, the digestion of proteins take place. These pepsins, they convert the proteins into peptides. So digestion of protein at here also takes place. Clear? So in the and this food is mixed, thoroughly mixed with this gastric juice in the stomach. Once the food is mixed with gastric juice, two things happen. What two things happen? One, dilute HCl is doing is killing the bacteria, the germs, and the